bag, something small. Take what you need and we disappear. Without a trace, we'll be gone, gone. The moon and the stars will follow the car. And then when we get to the ocean, we're gonna take a boat to the end of the world. All the way to the end of the world. Oh, and when the kids are old enough, we're gonna teach them to tied to the ground, not falling but rising like rolling around. Eyes closed above the rooftops. Eyes closed, we're gonna spin through the stars. Oh, when the kids are old enough, we're gonna teach them to fly. You and me together do anything, baby. You and me together.
You look amazing.
Thank you.
What is this? Can we live finally here?
Yeah.
It's all there. That's nice. Remember the handoff?
The handoff?
The handoff. The handoff.
That's cool. You'll just have to remind me.
I don't remember. So I just did this yesterday.
No.
What's that?
Nothing.
Don't fall.
Keep her on.
I'm working on it.
I know.
All right, man.
Much love, brother.
Okay.
Thank you. Jill.
Oh.
Got a hot mic.
Welcome. Please be seated. Today is a celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people who are ready to say, I do. To all of you with us today, Michael and Jillian want to say thank you. They are both so incredibly happy to share this moment with you. They also remember loved ones who cannot be here in person to share this moment. We have all been so lucky to play an important role in their lives. Some have watched them grow up, went to school with them, traveled with them, or worked with them. Some of us have even been there when Michael was really into building fish tanks, and we thought he might become, you know, one of those celebrity fish tank builders and be on TV, reality show or something. Because we are the ones who have supported Michael and Jillian and have known them so well, it is only fitting that we are the ones to share in this once-in-a-lifetime moment with them. As Justice Anthony Kennedy powerfully states, no union is more profound than marriage, for it embodies the highest ideals of love, fidelity, devotion, sacrifice, and family. In forming a marital union, two people become something greater than once they were. Love is so important in life, and especially in marriage. James Kavanaugh describes love in his poem titled, To Love Is Not to Possess. To love is not to possess, to own, or imprison, nor to lose oneself in another. Love is to join and separate, to walk alone and together, to find a laughing freedom that lonely isolation does not permit. It is finally to be able to be who we really are, no longer clinging in childish dependency, nor docilely living separate lives in silence. It is to be perfectly oneself and perfectly joined in permanent commitment to another and to one's inner self. Love only endures when it moves like waves, receding and returning gently or passionately, or moving lovingly like the tide and the moon's own predictable harmony. Because finally, despite a child's scars or an adult's deepest wounds, they are openly free to be who they really are and always secretly were in the very core of their being, where true and lasting love can alone abide. At this time, I would like to welcome Dan Isidoro to continue the ceremony.
Thank you, Alondra. It's really an incredible honor to have this opportunity to wed these two today. Michael and Jillian, you are truly amazing friends who have become family to me. First, though, I need to thank you for giving me over a year to think about what I'm going to say right now. Of course, during that time, it's only appropriate that I've been witness to top-notch officiants, some who have played guitar, orchestrated a sing-along, and there was even an Elvis impersonator. So there's no pressure here. But you see, Michael and Jillian's story started back in high school 12 years ago when they met innocently enough at a school dance. Since then, it's been one very well-planned adventure after the next. Adventures that all of us have shared special parts in, and one that's taking place right now. To be completely honest, Michael and Jillian are the best planners that I know. From the many themed backyard parties to numerous award-winning Halloween costumes, from road trips to Tampa and trips around the world, from each backbreaking move from apartment to apartment to apartment, And finally, through the home buying process. I see it in their career path they've chosen, and especially right down to this very day, their wedding day. Michael and Jillian are always working together towards achieving their goals, and they are successful because of how well they know each other. For example, Michael knew exactly how to convince Jillian to throw him a surprise 29th birthday party. I mean, engagement party. It involved having me suggest the perfect venue, the food he loved, and Oreo cookie frosting, which Jillian loves. But what really made their engagement so special was that even though they were planning it separately, everything that they put into planning that day revolved around how much they loved each other, how happy they wanted to make each other, and how well they knew each other. You know, over the past 8 years or so, nobody believed Michael when he would say that he wouldn't be getting married until he's 30. Or that Jillian would be patient enough to wait that long. But here we are. It was all part of their plan, and it has everything to do with how they have learned to approach life together. Reflecting back to the beautiful poem by James Kavanaugh that Alondra read, it's one that I think everyone should be able to relate to or be able to take away from. The strongest relationships, like Michael and Jillian's, are successful because of the ability for both people to be themselves and retain their individuality, while at the same time working together to overcome challenges and by being supportive of each other's goals. Remember that love will only endure when it moves like the waves. Now, Michael and Jillian, before you declare your vows to one another, I want to hear you confirm that it is indeed your intention to be married today. Jillian, do you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to Michael in marriage?
I do.
Michael, do you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to Jillian in marriage?
I do.
Michael and Jillian, are you, with your family and friends as your witnesses, ready to say your vows?
We are.
We are.
Jillian, you may begin.
Michael, for 12 years, you have been my constant source of love, laughter, support, sometimes annoyance, but always sheer happiness. Looking back, there are very few fond memories that don't involve you. In the beginning, we shared countless nights at the beach house, dates to the Providence Place Mall, and lengthy phone calls that often exceeded our family plan minutes. Then came the long-distance college days, crazy Tampa nights, and first apartments. We definitely tested each other, but have always stood by one another. I am so happy that I was able to grow with you and learn how to adult with you by my side. I loved you back then, but boy, do I love you even more right now. You're my inspiration and my go-to idea man. Two things which are crucial for me as the go-to party planner and crafter. I believe you may be the one person who can manage to change my mind on a decision and persuade me to go along with your ideas most of the time. Michael, thank you for being my best friend. The one who can cheer me up. The one who knows when to pour me a glass of wine and when to give me a snack. The one who takes care of me when I'm sick. The one who challenges me, the one who boosts my confidence, the one who shares my passions and values, the one who truly understands me, and the one who is always there. You will forever be my one. I promise you that I will always listen, really, truly listen, even to your over-the-top ideas and witty comebacks. I promise to support you in all your aspirations and adventures. I promise to put you, our relationship, and our family first. And I promise to love you deeply. Our life together is one I'm so proud of, and our future together fills me with so much excitement. I'm incredibly happy and feel extremely fortunate to become your wife. I am so in love with you, my partner now and always.
Michael. Now it's your turn.
So, I tried sitting down and writing my vows probably about 50 times by now. But every time, the words always escape me. To put into words how much you mean to me is impossible.
Every day I wake up, I think of how much I love you. I fall deeper and deeper in love with you every day. It's been in all the small moments in life, when it's just me and you, that I fall deeper in love with you. Whenever we're just laughing about something random, watching TV, or just living our everyday lives. It's in those small moments I realize how lucky I am. You are smart, beautiful, stubborn, and strong. And stubborn, did I say that? Yeah. You have always reminded me of the beautiful, strong women in my life. I've never been great at saying how I feel, but I can say in this moment, I love you with all my heart and can't imagine a day without you. I promise to keep you young by keeping you up to speed on all the latest trends, new music, and viral videos all the cool kids are watching. I promise to grow with you always on a daily basis. I promise to always be the calm in your storms, in any storm you're in. I promise to always live every dream that you have and support you fully. I promise to be the man you see before you today, and you've had a big hand in molding. I'm excited for the next chapter of our lives, and I can't wait to grow old with you.
You've both chosen to wear rings as a reminder of these promises. Your wedding rings are the outward and visible sign of the inward and invisible bond which already unites your two hearts in love. Jillian, place this ring on Michael's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
Just as this ring has no end.
Just as this ring has no end.
My love for you is forever.
My love for you is forever.
Right.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
Just as this ring has no end.
Just as this ring has no end.
My love for you is forever.
My love for you is forever.
May these wedding rings you exchange today remind you always that you are surrounded by enduring love. Having pledged their fidelity to one another, to love, honor, and cherish one another in the presence of this gathering, and by the authority vested in me by the Constitution and the laws of Massachusetts, it is my honor to now pronounce you husband and wife. Michael, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to be the very first person to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Jillian Silva.
Together for parents of the bride, Mr. and Mrs. Bruce and Jillian here. Let's hear it for them. Please welcome parents of the groom, Dr. and Mrs. Salah and Kathy Abdelrahman. Put your hands together for Sandy Barboza and Fernando De Lomba. Put your hands together for Holly Vieira, Garrett Vieira, and ring bearer Owen Vieira. Please welcome Amethyst Silva and Joseph Kendrigan. Please welcome Jessica Gina and Calvin Arterberry. Please welcome Caitlin Resendiz and Brandon Reese. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we have Maid of Honor Julie Peters escorted by Daniel Isidoro. For our Maid of Honor and Best Man, Amy Bousquet and Michael Isidoro. Please stand for the introductions of our bride and groom. Ladies and gentlemen, make as much noise as you possibly can. Please welcome the new Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Jillian Silva.
Baby, since the day you came into my life, you made me realize that we were born to fly. You showed me every day new possibilities. You proved my fantasy of love could really be. Let's go to a place only lovers go, to a spot that we've never known, to the top of the clouds we're floating away. Oh, this feels so crazy, and oh, this love is blaze, and baby, sail among the stars before the night is through. And when morning comes, we'll see the sun. It's not so far, and we can't get much closer to God than where we are. We'll go to a place only lovers go, to a spot that we've never known, to the top of the clouds we're floating away. And ooh, this feels so crazy, and oh, this love is blazing, and baby, we're so high,
So, first off, I want to thank Joanne and Bruce for all their love and support for the last 12 plus years and welcome me into the family from the start. I love you guys and I appreciate it. So I also want to thank the Vieiras, the Limas, Resendis, the Gilmets, all that family that we seem to hang out with a lot. So we love you guys and we thank you all for your support as well. To my parents, I can never thank you guys enough for everything you've done for me. You've been there through thick and thin, all my shenanigans, which I appreciate, and I never say no. Only a little bit. Luckily, me and Mike were pretty stealthy. But I'm going to keep this short, so we just want to thank you all for coming. It means the world to us that you could be here today and celebrate our next phase of our lives together. We look forward to the next steps and seeing you guys more. So I love you guys. Enjoy. We'll see you soon. And make sure you dance. That's it.
Hello. So bad. Well, for those of you that don't know me, my name is Amy Bousquet. And for those of you that are familiar with or don't know much about my relationship with Jillian, neither of us are particularly warm and fuzzy, so this will probably be a bit uncomfortable for both of us. Jillian and I have been best friends since before either of us can remember. You see, our mothers grew up one house apart from each other as best friends themselves. And they just so happened to give birth to baby girls within 3 months of each other. Jillian's Aunt Karen also gave birth to a baby girl within those 3 months. So from the very beginning, it was always me, Jillian, and Caitlin, the three musketeers. For us, the years have been filled with many laughs, tears, miles driven between Dartmouth and Tiverton, nights out on the town, nights in rewatching the First Wives Club, and to the frustration of our parents, sky-high long-distance phone bills when that was a thing. Being so close with Jillian and becoming friends with Mike our freshman year of high school, I've been fortunate enough to witness Jillian and Mike's relationship grow and evolve from the beginning. I never let Jillian forget that it was me who reintroduced her and Mike one night at Wonder Bowl, which is where their friendship started. And even when they were friends, you could tell that there was something between them. Mike would always pick on Jillian for being short and for throwing knuckleballs during beer pong. He even used to call her Tim Wakefield to get her fired up during a game. And Jillian never failed to steal Mike's hat at some point during the night. After a couple of years of being friends, their friendship started to become something more. I remember the first time Jillian told me and Caitlin that she had feelings for Mike. We were sitting at our kitchen table, eating some of Bruce's famous pancakes for breakfast. And yes, he still made us pancakes for breakfast, even though we were 17. Although he stopped making them Mickey Mouse shaped by that time. Anyways, the three of us were sitting there when Jill suddenly blurted out, "Guys, I think I like Mike." Turned out, not to anyone's surprise, Mike felt the same. And so it began. Watching Jillian and Mike's relationship grow throughout the course of several milestones, like college, birthdays, moving into their first, second, third and fourth homes together, and the many anniversaries before Mike finally put a ring on it, it's been evident that both of them are such a support for each other and truly work together as partners in every aspect of the word. I'm sure that each of you in this room will agree with me when I say that it's so refreshing to have as much confidence as I do that Jillian and Mike are ready to take on this next adventure in their lives together. So at this time, could everyone raise their drinks and cheers to the Silvas.
Did you cheers?
Here's it. Thank you, Amy, and thank you everyone else for being here. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Julie. And I mean, I like to think of myself as the comic relief of the group. Although, I know many of my friends would disagree because typically I'm usually the only one laughing at my jokes, but either way, we have a pretty good time. But in all seriousness, I've known Jillian now for about 8 years through Amy, actually. And I feel like when Amy realized she wasn't going to be able to get rid of me, she would pass me along to her other friends. So, and as Dan Isadora once said, I was persistent enough in trying to join their group that they eventually had to accept me as one of their own. Thank you, Dan. That being said, I've never been happier that my persistence paid off because we've had some amazing memories over the years. Although, for anyone who really does know me, knows that I have the worst memory. And I typically depend on Amy and Jill to remind me of the good times. And even just yesterday, poor Jillian had to remind me today was her wedding. So, but lucky for her, I didn't have any other plans. So here I am. No, but really, over the years, we have had some really good times, be it like parties at the beach house or combining our birthday celebrations, country fest, weekends on Saco, watching movies, or my favorite pastime, teaming up with Mike to torture Jill. I mean, if I had a nickel for every time we all went out and poor Jill was the third wheel, I feel like I could retire. But no, I'm just kidding. But as much as I loved going out with the whole gang, I feel like most of my favorite memories are of just us girls, especially our girls' trip to Greece. And it was the most amazing trip. We got to see the dancers and sing along to our favorite songs. No, I'm just kidding. For those of you who are confused, I'm talking about the play Greece, not the country. And I made that the same mistake, and we still have a pretty good laugh to this day. But anyways, although I haven't been there since the beginning like Amy, I can tell that there aren't two people more meant for each other than Mike and Jill. They've already been through so much together. They've graduated college. They've traveled together. They've had puppies. And they've bought a house. And finally, after Mike dragging his feet forever, they're getting married. And I can only imagine what greatness their future holds, but I count my lucky stars every day I get to be a part of it. Jillian and Mike, I wish you both nothing but the best, and through good times and bad, I know that your love for each other will only grow. So everybody raise your glasses and cheers to Jillian and Mike. Yeah. Cheers, Jill. Cheers, Mike. Amy.
All right. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mike Isadora, and I am proud to stand here with Mike and Jill as the best man. I do know their names. No. The first thing I'd like to do is say, Jillian, you look incredible, as always. And also, thank you to Bruce and Joanne for making this night possible. A very special thank you to the Abderrahmans. They brought me all around this great big world, and they're one of the biggest influences in my life. So thank you as well. Speaking of travel, thank you for everybody who came from near and far. I was definitely on the far end, but wouldn't miss this for the world. And for those who couldn't make it, you're in my prayers. That was supposed to be the easy part. But the first thing I'd like to say is, what took you guys so long? It's been uttered and spoken again and again, but 12 years, and you guys have been perfect from the start. All right. 12 years. When I sat down to write this speech, I felt like I was writing a 25-year anniversary speech. That might be because the first draft was 25 pages long. This is the abridged version, but that's also how long I've known Mike. 25 years. We met each other in kindergarten. By first grade, we were surgically attached at the hip. We've gone by like many nicknames, Mike and Mike, Eminem. My favorite is Double Trouble. So and Jill, I've known Jill 13, 14, almost as long as Mike has known Jill. She was a regular at the beach house with Caitlin, Bethany, and Amy. Julie came later, but we love her just the same. Seriously though, these two have been a huge part of my life and one of the best parts. So, 25 years of material on Mike, 13 on Jill. The moment you've all been waiting for, the roast of Mike and Jillian Silva. No, I wish. First of all, I've been roasting Jillian for like 13 years, so she has a well-deserved night off. You're welcome. And Mike, all right, I want everybody to scratch your heads and think of an embarrassing story of Mike. Please. Do you got anything? That's why this speech took me so long to write. I really have one on here. I've been deliberating whether I should say it or not. What do you guys? Now, Mike has one little imperfection. At parties during Beirut, it would rear its ugly head. But my favorite story was when we were working together, delivering phone books for the Yellow Pages. You guys might know what I'm talking about. If you've ever had more than two beers with Mike, you will know that he has a small splatter at the party. If you guys want the full details, I had to cut it out. But you'll find me at the bar, I'm sure. And all right, that's really all I got. That's not that bad, man. Like that you should be, yep. 25 years, and that's all the dirt I got on Mike. Most of my memories revolve around winning at pretty much everything we team up on. We're undefeatable. Chad, we've beaten you so many times. Like, it's not even... It's You might have gotten us once, but... But also our adventures abroad and killer parties. Well, but, okay. Oh, well. All right. So I know I've probably been going on for a while, but the speech was 25 pages. And, you know, 25 years can't be summed up in 25 pages or 1,000. You had to be there. I was lucky enough to be there for most of it. So, down to brass tacks, advice. Right? It's funny. Unfortunately, I don't have any words of wisdom for you two. There are no sacred words I have for you. You two wouldn't need it anyway. You've been doing this for a long time. You're perfect for each other. Mike's known that for 12 years. I'm pretty sure Jill has too. At least she's been planning that wedding for this long. All right, so I want to go on about Mike and tell you why he's my best friend. Because he always genuinely believed in me, this guy. Always. So much that I finally learned to believe in myself. How I can't even remember one of the most important days of my life, because it happened in first grade. One day when him and I decided to be friends rather than enemies, That's right. Nobody knows that, but we were not friends in kindergarten. He would send me home crying. But it's true. Oh, man. I can talk about Mike and Jill's unbelievable relationship. Amy covered that. And they were up against all odds. They started dating when all the high school power couples were fizzling out. After graduation, about a month before Mike flew 1,300 miles away from her. And they stuck through it. I thought he was crazy. It was his first girlfriend, real girlfriend. We don't count the imaginary ones anymore. But Mike never even blinked. I asked him, "Are you sure? Are you sure?" He knew it. 12 years ago. All right, I got a toast. I know this is a long speech, but I got something really, really special for Mike. All right, Mike told me one time that he had a really bad memory, but I don't want him to forget the story of us. So that's what this is. In chronological order from day one. And it rhymes. All right. It all started in kindergarten, teasing my hair. Then we became best friends through adventures in daycare. Countless sleepovers, Martha's Vineyard and Disney World. Beach fires, basketball, track meets, and the Caribbean, chasing girls. That was a long time ago, Jill. That's a long time ago. That was before. All right. Going down the beach to hang out with Dan, card games and yard games and road trips in my van. There was Tampa and Fiji and Saco 2, Hibernia catwalk and countless barbecues. With Dan, Brian, Joe just wasting the day, endless FIFA tournaments to Jill's dismay. And then Boston, Fall River, Hawaii, and Europe. Capecations too, Oakley, Coastal, and 81 Fairmount. Until suddenly my going away party, I was California bound. There were beers and tears and Black Hawk Down. But I came back for all the bachelor parties, some weddings too. And I saw his proposal. It was the least I could do. Which brings us to today. These two tying the knot. No surprise there, it's just like we thought. After 12 years of love, you two are the best. Congratulations, Mike and Jill. Can't wait to see what's next.
Gotta hold on easy as I let you go. Gonna tell you how much I love you, though you think you already know. I remember I thought you looked like an angel wrapped in pink, so soft and warm. You've had me wrapped around your finger since the day you were born. You beautiful baby from the outside in, chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on this old world. But to me, you know you'll always be. My little girl. When you were in trouble, that crooked little smile milled my heart of stone. Now look at you, I've turned around and you've almost grown. Sometimes you're asleep, I whisper I love you in the moonlight at your door. As I walk away, I hear you say, Daddy, love you more. You beautiful baby from the outside in, chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on the
but to me you know you'll always be. My little girl.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for our bride and her father? Let's hear it for them.
I love all y'all, but love me. but I love me.